How are you doing, everybody? This is Ray Zirkel, and you are getting loose with Bruce, heard every Monday here at 5 o'clock, my usual Springsteen extravaganza. Normally I start off with a song right away and then come on for a little bit, but this is a little bit different here for the next few weeks. I might still come on at the beginning of the shows, but just to kind of explain what I'm doing. Milwaukee, of course, the show that most of us here, at least three of us here in the radio station, attended on March the 3rd, finally came out in its official version. When I say official, the Springsteen camp has been going and making all of these shows available for download and then for purchase. So it's kind of nice. What I've decided to do, since this kind of wraps everything up, I got Tyler here. Tyler, how are you?
I'm great, and I think it sure does wrap everything up.
Yeah, nice, I mean, bow. You know, the whole thing started way back in, let's say, November.
Yeah, gosh, yeah.
With the release of the Box River, you know, River Set.
And we even started before. Just when they announced it.
That's right.
Or even when it was a rumor.
So it's been kind of a nonstop river
extravaganza.
I dipped out. I stepped out of the river last week for a brief second.
Last couple weeks.
But then I figured this will wrap it all up. We'll play the whole concert from start to finish over the next few weeks. Obviously, at an hour show, I can't play too much. I mean, it puts on 3.5 hours, so it's going to be at least probably 4 weeks.
Yeah, well, so, well worth it, though.
Well worth it.
So, I can attest. You can attest.
Yeah, I think it'll be nice and people get an idea. Now, the hardcore folks, you know, they probably either already heard most of these shows. And when I say hardcore, people that are really into it or maybe know how to download these shows or have purchased some already. If not, you get a nice feel for what the tour has been about. We had a little controversy this week. I don't know if most of you have heard that he canceled his show out there in North Carolina. Very mixed feelings out there. I went on several websites. Did you go on it?
It's really both sides.
I
understand everything.
Yeah, no, you have to look at everything from both sides.
Right.
There's a lot of mixed feelings. He took a stand, and if you know him, and I should know him, we don't know him, but if you know about him, or if you followed him, or you believe in his music and some of his ideals, message. That's a good one. His messages. He knows that he's all about equal rights for people, and this goes way back even to even as him supporting the vets back in 1980.
Chimes of Freedom.
Yeah, exactly. All this amnesty tours,
no nukes, and all this stuff.
Absolutely.
And you know he did those things for free. You know that he...
Absolutely. So, you know, he felt that it was right. Now, I do understand the other side of the coin. If you were somebody that were flying to that show, because a lot of folks do that, and you would purchase those tickets at a couple hundred, they're getting refunds at least, but it's not like they were out that money.
Well, if they bought them secondhand.
Secondhand. Yeah, you're out the cash.
Yeah, so, it is a shame, but the stance he's taking is a really righteous one.
Yes, it is. So, like I said, you can look at it from different sides, but it's all I'm going to say about it because, like you said, you could open up a whole can of worms. Huge can of worms. So, without much ado, I'm going to play the whole show. I'm going to just brief spots here in the middle of it and then get it wrapped up this week, and then we'll just continue it next week and see how many songs we can get. That was a 32-song show.
Yeah.
So, some good stuff. I was listening to it over the weekend. The quality is awesome, especially on the river when you can hear the whole audience singing the different verses.
Oh,
it sounds
great.
So good. All right, so anyway, we're going to start off. This is Milwaukee, March the 3rd, right?
March the 3rd.
You were there. You touched the man.
I touched the man.
Can I touch that? Which hand was
it? Yeah, it's my right hand. He reached out.
Touched.
Grab my right hand. And sparks
fly. Sparks fly. You're kind of clammy here.
I'm always clammy.
Yeah. All right. Anyway, so like I said, let's enjoy the show. And I'm, like I said, not even going to come back on. So I'll talk to you all next week. Thanks for listening. Here is the River Show from Milwaukee, March 3rd.
Good evening. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Coming-of-age record. It was the record where I was trying to figure out where I fit in. I'd taken notice of the things that bond people to their lives. By that time in my life, their work, commitments, families, I wanted to imagine and I wanted to write about those things. Figured if I could do that, I might get closer to having them in my own life. So that's what I did. I wanted to make a record that felt really big, a record that felt like life, or it felt like an East Street band show. I wanted the record to contain fun and dancing and laughter and jokes, good comradeship, love, sex, faith, lonely nights, and of course, teardrops. And I figured if I could make a record big enough to contain all those things, maybe I'd get a little closer to the answers and the home I was trying to find. So tonight, I want you to come with us as we go back down to the river and let's see what we find.
Heard you all cried out
scrapes on the tree. Turns a corner and drives down her street. A row of houses, she just melts away. Like the scenery in another man's mind. Into a house where the blinds are closed. They keep from saying things she don't want to know. She pulls the blinds and looks out on the street. With the cool of the night takes the edge off. They feed her in the Jackson Gate. Down in the Jackson Gate. You can try. You'll set before. There's always just one more day. There's always gonna be that way. Girl, you've been down here so long. I can tell by the way you move. You belong to the Jackson Gate. Down in the Jackson Gate. It don't matter just what you say. Are you tough enough to play the game? So downhearted, girl. I see you feeling so tired and confused. I wonder what it's worth to me or you. Just waiting to see some sun. Never knowing if that day will ever come. Left alone standing. Can you understand the way that it will turn a man into a stranger? To where next day. Independence Day was the first song I wrote about fathers and sons. It's the kind of song you write when you're young and you're first startled by your parents' humanity. You're shocked to find out that they have their own dreams and their own desires and their own hopes that maybe didn't pan out exactly as they thought it might. And all you can see are the adult compromises that they had to make. And you're still too young to see the blessings that come with those compromises. So all you can feel is the world closing in, closing in, closing in. And I know when I was young, all I could think about was getting out, getting out, getting out. So I had a very simple setting for this song. I set it around a kitchen table. It's just a late night conversation between two people that love each other but are struggling to understand one another. So this is Independence Day. Papa, go to bed now, it's getting late. Nothing we can say is gonna change anything now. I'll be leaving in the morning from St. Mary's Gate. We wouldn't change this thing, even if we could somehow. 'Cause the darkness of this house has got the best of us. There's a darkness in this town that's got us too. They can't touch me now. You can't touch me now. They ain't gonna do to me what I watch them do to you. So say goodbye. It's Independence Day. It's Independence Day all down the line. Just say goodbye. It's Independence Day. It's Independence Day this time. Now, I don't know just what it always was with us, but we chose the words, and yeah, we drew the lines. It was just no way that this house could hold the two of us. I guess that we were just too much of the same kind. Say goodbye, it's Independence Day. All boys must run away. Come Independence Day. Won't you just say goodbye? It's Independence Day. All men must make their way. Come Independence. She's deserted, clear down to Breakers Point. There's a lot of people leaving town now, leaving their friends, their homes. The night they walked was dark and dusty, highway all alone. Papa, go to bed now, it's getting late. Nothing we can say can change anything now. This is just different people coming down here now, and they see things in different ways. And soon everything we've known will just be swept away. So say goodbye, it's Independence Day. Papa, now I know the things you wanted that you could not say. Won't you just say goodbye, it's Independence Day. I swear I never meant to take those things away.
Hi, this is Liam. You're listening to WRLRLP FM 98.3.
Yeah, thank you very much, Liam. We are back with Getting Loose with Bruce. Heard every Monday here at 5 o'clock on WRLR 98.3 out of Round Lake Heights, Illinois. And what I'm doing is a special, next few weeks, actually. I'm running the whole Milwaukee show from this current tour. This was from March 3rd. This past month, and like I said, just running it continuous, and it's going to take a few weeks because he plays 3.5 hour shows. So let's continue on, and then like I said, thanks for listening. We're just going to sign off here, and at the end here, before Tyler comes on with Garage Noise at 6. So continuing the show from March 3rd, this is Bruce.
Come on. window and a voice said in the dark.